Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here today. One of the things I hear a lot is there's no evidence for Jesus Christ from the first century, two centuries of his life. And, you know, and people have different variations. Well, we believe Jesus lived, but we don't think he did miracles, on and on and so forth. So I was going to read something. I wrote a book a while back about ancient historical evidence of Jesus. I plan on getting it republished, got some new things to put in there. But I'm going to read to you about a Roman historian by the name of Suetonius. And it's just a couple paragraphs in here, but I think you might find it interesting. So Suetonius says, next we come to Gaius Suetonius Tranquillus, 69 to 140 AD, a court official under Emperor Hadrian. In 112 AD, writing in his famous Life of the 12 Caesars, and that's a very famous book, he also speaks at least once about Christians. He says this, punishment was inflicted on the Christians, a class of men addicted to a novel and mischievous superstition. That's in his Life of Nero, 16:3. And then another reference, he says, as the Jews were making constant disturbances at the instigation of Crestus, he expelled them from Rome. And that's the Life of Claudius, 25:4. Now that is strikingly reminiscent of Acts 18:1-2, which records that the Jews being expelled from Rome during the reign of Claudius. Now the name Crestus, some people have said that that was a common name. Let's read about that. Well, used in reference to Jesus was also in common name of the time, and so historians are hesitant to state conclusively that the last reference is a reference to Jesus. But from the unmistakable first reference, we learn that there was a group of people in 64 AD which were referred to as Christians, which had a novel seeming to indicate a rather new superstition, meaning it was related to religion. We know it was in Acts 11:26. People were first called Christians. So this is written just a couple decades after that, saying that is in fact what their name was. This corroborates well with the Tacitus account of the same period concerning Jesus and his followers. Now, not only do you have the four Gospels, which are historical documents, even if you don't believe the Bible's inspired, you have to take these as historical documents, and that we have records of them. Many cases, it's being found out, maybe even into the first century AD. And so the fact that there were Christians, they had to have an originator, all this type thing. So it's very much untenable to say Jesus was not a historical personage. There's overwhelming amounts of evidence. Now, one of the fascinating things in talking to unbelievers over the past several months is they would say, we don't believe in history. We don't even believe in the science of history. And the reason they abandon it is because they're like, if we say there is history and there's historical methods and historical methodology, then we're going to have to admit that there was a person of Jesus Christ and that he did miracles and he was who he said he was, really. And so Suetonius, this is just one of immense amounts of proofs and evidences of Jesus Christ from the first century AD. Go ahead and believe it is the greatest thing you could ever do. Jesus, God in flesh, God entered the world to save mankind, to save you and I, and he wants us to come to him. He loves us, and he's pulling at your heart right now, and you just need to ask God to forgive you of all your sins and go ahead and receive his beautiful gift of the Holy Spirit, eternal life living on the inside of you. He'll fill you with his Spirit, and then get water baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. Find a church that believes that, and then go to a holiness, Bible-believing church, because straight is the gate, narrow is the way that leads to eternal life, and few there be that find it, but broad is the way. Even as Virgil said, you know, that there's a wide gate that leads to hell, and a wide path. So just believe Jesus Christ. The history is overwhelming. The evidence is overwhelming. He did exist. He loves you. God bless you in Jesus' name.